seen the hint of raw sex in them. My hands went to the askew for a brassiere I was wearing. I undid it, tossed those breast cups aside. My tits stood out, big and bold. They were hard as rocks, and those nipples were long. I threw back my shoulders and shook them. They did their dance, they jumped and shook. Simon moaned, but he did not move. My hands dropped to the skimpy thing about my hips. It fell down my thighs and I was naked. I ran my palms up and down my body invitingly. My fingertips slid into my pubic bush. I inched forward toward him. I touched his straining penis. I pressed it, moving slowly. Simon closed his eyes and jammed out his hips. I moved still closer, so that I held him between my hot thighs. I squeezed slowly, gently. How long do you think I can stand this? He gasped. As long as Mama wants to play. My fingernails scratched his hide, not hard but lazily, and he caressed. All the time my thighs were squeezing and releasing him. It was getting to the point where it wasn't easy for me to do this. I wanted what was between my thighs just as much as he wanted to slide it into me. I opened my legs and turned and walked away. My buttocks shook richly, rumbling. I looked back over my shoulder at Simon and he must have seen something in my eyes because he came after me, walking slowly, as if in some sort of daze. When we were in the bedroom, I lay down on the bed and lifted my legs. I bent them backward until my knees were almost touching my breasts. Simon stood there and stared between them. I didn't have to say anything. He got on the bed and thrust hard at me. He went deep. I felt him fill me up, and I gave a faint gasp. Then my hips began to work. Back and forth, around and around, my hips went. I carried Simon with me. He added his own rhythm. He knew his way around the woman, I had to admit. He was damn good. I just lay there and absorbed all he had to give me. And it was plenty. We were like machines in one sense. We never tired. It went on and on. But eventually, Simon took him in my arms, plunged deeply, and then exploded. I held him in my arms with his weight resting on me, and we fell asleep that way. My last conscious thought before I, too, drifted into dreamland was that whatever was down at the bottom of the Aegean Sea could wait another day or so. It had been there a long time. It would be there when I got there. At least, I hoped it would. Chapter 11. Frankly, I was ready to shack up with Simon for a day or two, but he was impatient to get started on that salvage job in the Aegean. It had come to me that I really wasn't paying very much attention to my own job, which was to check out that center. However, since I had the gut feeling that what Simon Mansfeld was doing would be related in some way to that center, I went right along with him. When we woke up, he leaned over and kissed my mouth very tenderly. "Time to get going," he murmured softly. I thought he meant get going on what we had been doing last night, so I put out my hand to grasp his male pride. To my surprise, he wriggled away. "I don't mean that. I mean out there in the Aegean. I've traveled. Do we have to be so worked in life? Can't we put it off until tomorrow?" He shook his head. He was as bad as Fletcher Atkins' son. I sighed, dribbled deeper under the covers, and told him to have fun. "Hey, come on. You're the one who knows where those rocks are." "I don't." "You were underwater at the time." "Right." I threw back the covers and slid my bare feet out onto the rug. It was cold out there and I almost turned back to get into bed again. But Simon was a small cookie. He my skirt. Then let's get going. Sammy, we have work to do. We drove into Volos and hunted the docks until we found a man who did some diving for sunken treasure.